This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Ireland ˈaɪərlənd, Irish, Eire. Joined the European Economic Community EEC, the predecessor of the European Union. In 1973, the state had no formal relations with Northern Ireland for most of the 20th century, but during the 1980s and 1990s, the British and Irish governments worked with the Northern Ireland parties towards a resolution to the Troubles. Since the signing of the Good Friday Agreement in 1998, the Irish government and Northern Ireland executive have co-operated on a number of policy areas under the North-South Ministerial Council. Created by the agreement, Ireland ranks among the top 25 wealthiest countries in the world in terms of GDP per capita, and is the 10th most prosperous country in the world according to the Legatum Prosperity Index 2015. After joining the EEC, Ireland enacted a series of liberal economic policies that resulted in rapid economic growth. The country achieved considerable prosperity between the years of 1995 and 2007, which became known as the Celtic Tiger period. This was halted by an unprecedented financial crisis that began in 2008, in conjunction with the concurrent global economic crash. However, as the Irish economy was the fastest growing in the EU in 2015, Ireland is again quickly ascending league tables comparing wealth and prosperity internationally. For example, in 2015, Ireland was ranked as the joint sixth with Germany most developed country in the world by the United Nations Human Development Index. It also performs well in several national performance metrics, including freedom of the press, economic freedom and civil liberties. Ireland is a member of the European Union and is a founding member of the Council of Europe and the OECD. The Irish government has followed a policy of military neutrality through non-alignment since immediately prior to World War II, and the country is consequently not a member of NATO, although it is a member in Partnership for Peace. Contents 1 Name 2 History 21 Home Rule Movement 22 Revolution and Steps to Independence 23 Irish Civil War 24 1937 Constitution 25 Recent History 3 Geography 31 Climate 4 Politics 41 Local Government 42 Law 43 Foreign Relations 44 Military 5 Economy 51 Development 52 Trade 53 Energy 54 Transport 6 Demographics 61 Functional Urban Areas 62 Languages 63 Healthcare 64 Education 65 Religion 7 Culture 71 Literature 72 Music and Dance 73 Architecture 74 Media 75 Cuisine 76 Sports 77 Society 78 State Symbols 8 See also 9 Notes 10 References 101 Bibliography 11 Further Reading 12 External Links Name Main Article, Names of the Irish State. The 1922 state, comprising 26 of the 32 counties of Ireland, was styled and known as the Irish Free State. The Constitution of Ireland, adopted in 1937, provides that the name of the state is Eire, or, in the English language, Ireland. Section 2 of the Republic of Ireland Act 1948 states, it is hereby declared that the description of the state shall be the Republic of Ireland. The 1948 Act does not name the state as Republic of Ireland, because to have done so would have put it in conflict with the Constitution. The government of the United Kingdom used the name Éire without the diacritic, and, from 1949, Republic of Ireland, for the state. It was not until the 1998 Good Friday Agreement that it used the name Ireland as well as Ireland, Eire, or the Republic of Ireland. The state is also referred to as the Republic, Southern Ireland, or the South. In an Irish Republican context, it is often referred to as the Free State or the 26 Counties. History Main Article, History of the Republic of Ireland. For the history of the entire island, see History of Ireland. Home Rule Movement. Main Article, Home Rule Movement. From the Act of Union on 1 January 1801, until 6 December 1922, the island of Ireland was part of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Ireland during the Great Famine. From 1845 to 1849, the island's population of over 8 million fell by 30%. 1 million Irish died of starvation and/or disease, and another 15 million emigrated, mostly to the United States. This set the pattern of emigration for the century to come, resulting in a constant population decline up to the 1960s. The Irish Parliamentary Party was formed in 1882 by Charles Stuart Parnell 1846-1891 from 1874, and particularly under Charles Stuart Parnell from 1880, the Irish Parliamentary party gained prominence. This was firstly through widespread agrarian agitation via the Irish Land League, that won land reforms for tenants in the form of the Irish Land Acts, and secondly through its attempts to achieve home rule, via two unsuccessful bills which would have granted Ireland limited national autonomy. These led to grassroots control of national affairs, under the Local Government Act 1898, that had been in the hands of landlord-dominated grand juries of the Protestant ascendancy. Home rule seemed certain when the Parliament Act 1911 abolished the veto of the House of Lords, and John Redmond secured the Third Home Rule Act in 1914. However, the Unionist movement had been growing since 1886 among Irish Protestants after the introduction of the first Home Rule Bill, fearing discrimination and loss of economic and social privileges if Irish Catholics achieved real political power in the late 19th and early 20th century. Unionism was particularly strong in parts of Ulster, where industrialisation was more common in contrast to the more agrarian rest of the island. It was feared that any tariff barriers would heavily affect that region. In addition, the Protestant population was more prominent in Ulster, with a majority in four counties under the leadership of the Dublin-born Sir Edward Carson of the Irish Unionist Party and the Ulsterman Sir James Craig of the Ulster Unionist Party. Unionists became strongly militant in order to oppose the coercion of Ulster. After the Home Rule Bill passed Parliament in May 1914, to avoid rebellion with Ulster, the British Prime Minister H.H. Asquith introduced an amending bill reluctantly conceded to by the Irish party leadership. This provided for the temporary exclusion of Ulster from the workings of the bill for a trial period of 6 years, with an as yet undecided new set of measures to be introduced for the area to be temporarily excluded. Revolution and steps to independence. Easter Proclamation, 1916. Though it received the royal assent and was placed on the statute books in 1914, the implementation of the Third Home Rule Act was suspended until after the First World War, which diffused the threat of civil war in Ireland with hope of ensuring the implementation of the Act at the end of the war through Ireland's engagement in the war. Redmond and his Irish National Volunteers supported Britain and its allies. 175,000 men joined Irish regiments of the 10th Irish and 16th Irish Divisions of the new British Army, while Unionists joined the 36th Ulster Divisions. The remainder of the Irish Volunteers, who opposed any support of Britain, launched an armed insurrection against British rule in the 1916 Easter Rising, together with the Irish Citizen Army. This commenced on 24 April 1916 with the Declaration of Independence after a week of heavy fighting, primarily in Dublin. The surviving rebels were forced to surrender their positions. The majority were imprisoned, but 15 of the prisoners, including most of the leaders, were executed as traitors to Britain. This included Patrick Pearse, the spokesman for the Rising and who provided the signal to the Volunteers to start the Rising, as well as James Connolly, socialist and founder of the Industrial Workers of the World Union and both the Irish and Scottish labour movements. These events, together with the conscription crisis of 1918, had a profound effect on changing public opinion in Ireland. In January 1919, after the December 1918 general election, 73 of Ireland's 106 members of Parliament MPs elected were Sinn Féin members who refused to take their seats in the British House of Commons. Instead, they set up an Irish Parliament called Dáil Éireann. This first Dáil in January 1919 issued a Declaration of Independence and proclaimed an Irish Republic. The declaration was mainly a restatement of the 1916 proclamation with the additional provision that Ireland was no longer a part of the United Kingdom. The new Irish Republic was recognised internationally only by the Russian Soviet Republic. The Irish Republic's Éireachtas Minister sent a delegation under Cian Comhairle, head of council, or speaker, of the Dáil Seán T. O'Kelly to the Paris Peace Conference of 1919, but it was not admitted. In 1922 a new parliament called the Oireachtas was established, of which Dáil Éireann became the lower house after the War of Independence and truce called in July 1921. Representatives of the British government and the Irish treaty delegates, led by Arthur Griffith, Robert Barton and Michael Collins, negotiated the Anglo-Irish Treaty in London from the 11th of October to the 6th of December 1921. The Irish delegates set up headquarters at Hans Place in Knightsbridge, and it was here in private discussions that the decision was taken on the 5th of December to recommend the treaty to Dáil Éireann. The second Dáil Éireann narrowly ratified the treaty in accordance with the treaty. On the 6th of December 1922 the entire island of Ireland became a self-governing dominion called the Irish Free State. Saoirstadt Éireann, under the Constitution constitution of the Irish Free State, the Parliament of Northern Ireland had the option to leave the Irish Free State 1 month later and return to the United Kingdom during the intervening period. The powers of the Parliament of the Irish Free State and Executive Council of the Irish Free State did not extend to Northern Ireland. Northern Ireland exercised its right under the treaty to leave the new Dominion and rejoined the United Kingdom on 8 December 1922. It did so by making an address to the King requesting that the powers of the Parliament and government of the Irish Free State shall no longer extend to Northern Ireland. The Irish Free State was a constitutional monarchy sharing a monarch with the United Kingdom and other dominions of the British Commonwealth. The country had a Governor-General representing the monarch, a bicameral parliament, a cabinet called the Executive Council, and a Prime Minister called the President of the Executive Council. Irish Civil War. Éamon de Valera 1882-1975. The Irish Civil War was the consequence of the creation of the Irish Free State anti-treaty forces, led by Éamon de Valera, objected to the fact that acceptance of the treaty abolished the Irish Republic of 1919 to which they had sworn loyalty, arguing in the face of public support for the settlement that the people have no right to do wrong. They objected most to the fact that the state would remain part of the British Empire and that members of the Free State Parliament would have to swear what the anti-treaty side saw as an oath of fidelity to the British King. Pro-treaty forces, led by Michael Collins, argued that the treaty gave not the ultimate freedom that all nations aspire to and develop, but the freedom to achieve it. At the start of the war, the Irish Republican Army IRA split into two opposing camps, a pro-treaty IRA and an anti-treaty IRA. The pro-treaty IRA disbanded and joined the new National Army. However, because the anti-treaty IRA lacked an effective command structure and because of the pro-treaty FOSS's defensive tactics throughout the war, Michael Collins and his pro-treaty forces were able to build up an army with many tens of thousands of World War I veterans from the 1922 disbanded Irish regiments of the British Army, capable of overwhelming the anti-treatyists' British supplies of artillery, aircraft, machine guns and ammunition boosted pro-treaty forces, and the threat of a return of Crown forces to the Free State removed any doubts about the necessity of enforcing the treaty. The lack of public support for the anti-treaty forces, often called the Irregulars, and the determination of the government to overcome the Irregulars contributed significantly to their defeat. 1937 Constitution. Following a national referendum, on 29 December 1937 the new Constitution of Ireland Bunreacht na hÉireann came into force. This replaced the Constitution of the Irish Free State and called the State Ireland, or Éire in Irish. Articles 2 and 3 of the Constitution asserted a nominal territorial claim over the whole island, considering the partition of Ireland under the 1922 Anglo-Irish Treaty illegitimate. The former Irish Free State government had taken steps to abolish the office of Governor-General some months before the new constitution came into force. Although the constitution established the office of President of Ireland, the question over whether Ireland was a republic remained open. Diplomats were accredited to the King, but the President exercised the internal functions of a head of state. For instance, the President gave assent to new laws with his own authority, without reference to King George VI. George VI was only an organ that was provided for by statute law. Ireland remained neutral during World War II, a period it described as the emergency. Ireland's link with the Commonwealth was terminated with the passage of the Republic of Ireland Act 1948, which came into force on 18 April 1949 and declared that the state was a republic at the time. A declaration of a republic terminated Commonwealth membership. This rule was changed 10 days after Ireland declared itself a republic, with the London Declaration of 28 April 1949. Ireland did not reapply when the rules were altered to permit republics to join later. The Crown of Ireland Act was repealed in Ireland by the Statute Law Revision Pre-Union Irish Statutes Act, 1960. Recent history. In 1973 Ireland joined the European Economic Community along with the United Kingdom and Denmark. The country signed the Lisbon Treaty. In 2007 Ireland became a member of the United Nations. In December 1955, after having been denied membership because of its neutral stance during the Second World War and not supporting the Allied cause at the time, joining the UN involved a commitment to using force to deter aggression by one state against another if the UN thought it was necessary. Interest towards membership of the European Economic Community EEC developed in Ireland during the 1950s, with consideration also given to membership of the European Free Trade Area as the United Kingdom intended on EEC membership. Ireland applied for membership in July 1961 due to the substantial economic linkages with the United Kingdom. However, the founding EEC members remained skeptical regarding Ireland's economic capacity, neutrality, and unattractive Protectionist policy. Many Irish economists and politicians realised that economic policy reform was necessary. The prospect of EEC membership became doubtful in 1963 when French President General Charles de Gaulle stated that France opposed Britain's accession, which ceased negotiations with all other candidate countries. However, in 1969 his successor, Georges Pompidou, was not opposed to British and Irish membership. Negotiations began and in 1972 the Treaty of Accession was signed. A referendum held in 1972 confirmed Ireland's entry, and it finally joined the EEC in 1973. The economic crisis of the late 1970s was fueled by the Fianna Fáil government's budget, the abolition of the car tax, excessive borrowing, and global economic instability, including the 1979 oil crisis. There were significant policy changes from 1989 onwards, with economic reform, tax cuts, welfare reform, an increase in competition, and a ban on borrowing to fund current spending. This policy began in 1989-1992 by the Fianna Fáil, Progressive Democrat government, and continued by the subsequent Fianna Fáil, Labour government and Fine Gael, Labour, Democratic Left government. Ireland became one of the world's fastest growing economies by the late 1990s in what was known as the Celtic Tiger period, which lasted until the global financial crisis of 2007-08. However, since 2014, Ireland has experienced strong economic growth in the Northern Ireland question. The British and Irish governments started to seek a peaceful resolution to the violent conflict involving many paramilitaries and the British Army in Northern Ireland known as the Troubles. A peace settlement for Northern Ireland, known as the Good Friday Agreement, was approved in 1998 in referendums north and south of the border as part of the peace settlement. The territorial claim to Northern Ireland in Articles 2 and 3 of the Constitution of Ireland was removed by referendum. Geography. Main article, Geography of Ireland. The Cliffs of Moher on the Atlantic coast. The state extends over an area of about 5,670,273 kilometres or 240 miles in length. The west coast is more rugged than the east, with numerous islands, peninsulas, headlands and bays. Deciduous woodland in County Kerry, with the ground covered in Ramsay's wild garlic before the arrival of the first settlers in Ireland about 9,000 years ago. The land was largely covered by forests of oak, ash, elm, hazel, yew, and other native trees. The growth of blanket bog and the extensive clearing of woodland to facilitate farming are believed to be the main causes of deforestation during the following centuries. Today, about 12% of Ireland is forested, of which a significant majority is composed of mainly non-native coniferous plantations for commercial use. Ideal soil conditions, high rainfall and a mild climate give Ireland the highest growth rates for forests in Europe. Hedgerows, which are traditionally used to define land boundaries, are an important substitute for woodland habitat, providing refuge for native wild flora and a wide range of insect, bird and mammal species. Glendalough Valley in County Wicklow. Agriculture accounts for about 64% of the total land area. This has resulted in limited land to preserve natural habitats, in particular for larger wild mammals with greater territorial requirements. The long history of agricultural production coupled with modern agricultural methods, such as pesticide and fertilizer use, has placed pressure on biodiversity. Climate. Main article, Climate of Ireland. The Atlantic Ocean and the warming influence of the Gulf Stream affect weather patterns in Ireland. Temperatures differ regionally, with central and eastern areas tending to be more extreme. However, due to a temperate oceanic climate, temperatures are seldom lower than -5.100 years from 1881 to 1980 was 1887. According to measurements made at the Phoenix Park in Dublin, 1980 was the dullest. Politics. Main article, Politics of the Republic of Ireland. President Michael D. Higgins. Ireland is a constitutional republic with a parliamentary system of government. The Oireachtas is the bicameral national parliament composed of the President of Ireland and the two houses of the Oireachtas, Seanad Éireann Senate and Dáil Éireann House of Representatives. Aras and Uachtarán is the official residence of the President of Ireland, while the Houses of the Oireachtas meet at Leinster House in Dublin. The President serves as head of state, and is elected for a 7-year term and may be re-elected once. The President is primarily a figurehead, but is entrusted with certain constitutional powers with the advice of the Council of State. The office has absolute discretion in some areas, such as referring a bill to the Supreme Court for a judgment on its constitutionality. Michael D. Higgins became the 9th President of Ireland on the 11th of November 2011. The Taoiseach Prime Minister serves as the head of government and is appointed by the President upon the nomination of the Dáil. Most Dáiseachs have served as the leader of the Political party that gains the most seats in national elections. It has become customary for coalitions to form a government, as there has not been a single party government since 1989. Enda Kenny assumed the office of Taoiseach on 9 March 2011. Taoiseach Enda Kenny. The Seanad is composed of 60 members, with 11 nominated by the Taoiseach, 6 elected by 2 universities, and 43 elected by public representatives from panels of candidates established on a vocational basis. The Dáil has 158 members. Taoiseach Dála elected to represent multi-seat constituencies under the system of proportional representation and by means of the single transferable vote. The government is constitutionally limited to 15 members. No more than 2 members can be selected from the Seanad, and the Taoiseach, Tánaiste Deputy Prime Minister and Minister for Finance must be members of the Dáil. The Dáil must be dissolved within 5 years after its first meeting following the previous election, and a general election for members of the Dáil must take place no later than 30 days after the dissolution. According to the Constitution of Ireland, parliamentary elections must be held at least every 7 years, though a lower limit may be set by statute law. The current government is a Fine Gael-led minority government led by Enda Kenny as Taoiseach and Francis Fitzgerald as Tánaiste. It is supported by a number of independents including Shane Ross and former Senator Catherine Zappone. The minority government is held in place by a confidence and supply deal with Fianna Fáil. Opposition parties in the current Dáil are Fianna Fáil, Sinn Féin, the Socialist Party, the PBPA and Anti-Austerity Alliance, the Labour Party, Social Democrats, the WUAG, the Green Party, as well as a number of independents. Government buildings. Ireland has been a member state of the European Union since 1973, but has chosen to remain outside the Schengen area. Citizens of the United Kingdom can freely enter the country without a passport due to the Common Travel Area, which is a passport-free zone comprising the islands of Ireland, Great Britain, the Isle of Man and the Channel Islands. However, some identification is required at airports and seaports. Local government. Main article, local government in the Republic of Ireland. The Local Government Act 1898 is the founding document of the present system of local government, while the 20th Amendment to the Constitution of 1999 provided for its constitutional recognition. The 26 traditional counties of Ireland are not always coterminous with administrative divisions, although they are generally used as a geographical frame of reference by the population of Ireland. The Local Government Reform Act 2014 provides for a system of 31 local authorities, 26 county councils, 2 city and county councils and 3 city councils. Below this, with the exception of the Dublin region and the 3 city councils, are municipal districts, replacing a previous system of town councils. Fingal, Dublin City, Dun, Leary, Rathdown, South Dublin, Wicklow, Wexford, Carlow, Kildare, Meath, Louth, Monaghan, Cavan, Longford, Westmeath, Offaly, Louth, Kilkenny, Waterford, Cork City, Cork, Kerry, Limerick, Tipperary, Clare, Galway, Galway City, Mayo, Roscommon, Sligo, Leitrim, Donegal. Local authorities are responsible for matters such as planning, local roads, sanitation, and libraries. Dáil constituencies are required to follow county boundaries as much as possible. Counties with greater populations have multiple constituencies, some of more than one county, but generally do not cross county boundaries. The counties are grouped into 8 regions, each with a regional authority composed of members delegated by the various county and city councils in the region. The regions do not have any direct administrative role as such, but they serve for planning, coordination and statistical purposes. Law. Main articles, Law of Ireland, Courts of Ireland, and Law Enforcement in the Republic of Ireland. The 4 courts, completed in 1802, is the location of the Supreme Court, the High Court and the Dublin Circuit Court. Ireland has a common law legal system with a written constitution that provides for a parliamentary democracy. The court system consists of the Supreme Court, the Court of Appeal, the High Court, the Circuit Court and the District Court, all of which apply the law of Ireland. Trials for serious offences must usually be held before a jury. The High Court and the Supreme Court have authority, by means of judicial review, to determine the compatibility of laws and activities of other institutions of the state with the constitution and the law, except in exceptional circumstances. Court hearings must occur in public. The Criminal Courts of Justice is the principal building for the criminal courts. It includes the Dublin Metropolitan District Court, Court of Criminal Appeal, Dublin Circuit Criminal Court and Central Criminal Court. The Criminal Courts of Justice is the principal building for criminal courts. Garda Shashana na HÉireann, Guardians of the Peace of Ireland, more commonly referred to as the Gardaí, is the state's civilian police force. The force is responsible for all aspects of civil policing, both in terms of territory and infrastructure. It is headed by the Garda Commissioner, who is appointed by the government. Most uniformed members do not routinely carry firearms. Standard policing is traditionally carried out by uniformed officers equipped only with a baton and pepper spray. The military police is the core of the Irish Army, responsible for the provision of policing service personnel and providing a military police presence to forces while on exercise and deployment in wartime. Additional tasks include the provision of a traffic control organization to allow rapid movement of military formations to their mission areas. Other wartime roles include control of prisoners of war and refugees. Ireland's citizenship laws relate to the island of Ireland, including islands and seas, thereby extending them to Northern Ireland, which is part of the United Kingdom. Therefore, anyone born in Northern Ireland who meets the requirements for being an Irish citizen, such as birth on the island of Ireland to an Irish or British citizen parent or a parent who is entitled to live in Northern Ireland or the Republic without restriction on their residency, may exercise an entitlement to Irish citizenship, such as an Irish passport. Foreign Relations. Main article, Foreign Relations of the Republic of Ireland. See also, Ireland-NATO relations. Foreign relations are substantially influenced by membership of the European Union, although bilateral relations with the United Kingdom and United States are also important. It held the presidency of the Council of the European Union on 6 occasions, most recently from January to June 2013. Ireland has been a member state of the European Union since 1973. Ireland tends towards independence in foreign policy, thus the country is not a member of NATO and has a long-standing policy of military neutrality. This policy has helped the Irish Defence Forces to be successful in their contributions to peacekeeping missions with the United Nations since 1960, during the Congo crisis and subsequently in Cyprus, Lebanon and Bosnia and Herzegovina. Despite Irish neutrality during World War II, Ireland had more than 50,000 participants in the war through enlistment in the British Armed Forces during the Cold War. Irish military policy, while ostensibly neutral, was biased towards NATO during the Cuban Missile Crisis. Sean Lamass authorized the search of Cuban and Czechoslovak aircraft passing through Shannon and passed the information to the CIA. Ireland's air facilities were used by the United States military for the delivery of military personnel involved in the 2003 invasion of Iraq through Shannon Airport. The airport had previously been used for the invasion of Afghanistan in 2001, as well as the first Gulf War since 1999. Ireland has been a member of NATO's Partnership for Peace PFP program and NATO's Euro-Atlantic Partnership Council EAPC, which is aimed at creating trust between NATO and other states in Europe and the former Soviet Union military. Main article, Defence Forces. Ireland Irish Army. Mawag Piranha AFV. At 2006 Easter Military Parade in Dublin. The Defence Forces are made up of the Army, Naval Service, Air Corps and Reserve Defence Force. It is small but well equipped, with almost 10,000 full-time military personnel and over 2,000 in reserve. Ireland is a neutral country, and has triple lock rules governing the participation of Irish troops in conflict zones, whereby approval must be given by the UN. The Dáil Éireann government. Daily deployments of the Defence Forces cover aid to civil power operations, protection and patrol of Irish territorial waters and EEZ by the Irish Naval Service, and UN, EU and PFP peacekeeping missions. By 1996, over 40,000 Irish service personnel had served in international UN peacekeeping missions. The Irish Air Corps is the air component of the Defence Forces and operates 16 fixed-wing aircraft and 8 helicopters. The Irish Naval Service is Ireland's navy, and operates 8 patrol ships, and smaller numbers of inflatable boats and training vessels, and has armed boarding parties capable of seizing a ship and a special unit of frogmen. The military includes the Reserve Defence Forces Army Reserve and Naval Service Reserve for part-time reservists. Ireland's special forces include the Army Ranger Wing, which trains and operates with international special operations units. The President is the formal supreme commander of the Defence Forces, but in practice answers to the government via the Minister for Defence Economy. Main article, Economy of the Republic of Ireland. Ireland is part of the EU dark blue Companies such as Intel invested in Ireland during the late 1980s, later followed by Microsoft and Google. Ireland is ranked as the 9th most economically free economy in the world, according to the Index of Economic Freedom in terms of GDP per capita. Ireland is one of the wealthiest countries in the OECD and EU. However, the country ranks below the OECD average in terms of GNP per capita. GDP is significantly greater than GNP due to the large number of multinational corporations based in Ireland. Ireland beginning in the early 1990s, the country experienced unprecedented economic growth fueled by a dramatic rise in consumer spending, construction and investment, which became known as the Celtic Tiger period. The pace of growth slowed during 2007 and led to the burst of a major property bubble which had developed over time. The dramatic fall in property prices highlighted the overexposure of the economy to construction and contributed to the Irish banking crisis. Ireland officially entered a recession in 2008 following consecutive months of economic contraction. GNP contracted by 113% in 2009 alone, the largest annual decline in GNP since 1950. The country officially exited recession in 2010, assisted by a strong growth in exports. However, due to a significant rise in the cost of public borrowing due to government guarantees of private banking debt, the Irish government accepted an €85 billion program of assistance from the EU, International Monetary Fund IMF, and bilateral loans from the United Kingdom. Sweden and Denmark. Following 3 years of contraction, the economy grew by 0.7% in 2011 and 0.9% in 2012. The unemployment rate was 147% in 2012, including 185% among recent immigrants. In March 2016, the unemployment rate was reported by the Central Statistics Office Ireland to be 86%, down from a peak unemployment rate of 151% in February 2012. In addition to unemployment, net emigration from Ireland between 2008 and 2013 totaled 120,100, or some 26% of the total population. According to the Census of Ireland 2011, one-third of the emigrants were aged between 15 and 24 in 2013. Ireland was named the best country for business by Forbes. Ireland exited its EU IMF bailout program on 15 December 2013, having implemented budget cuts, reforms, and sold assets. Ireland was again able to access debt markets since then. Ireland has been able to sell long-term bonds at record rates. Trade. The International Financial Services Centre in Dublin, with the Famine Memorial. Although multinational corporations dominate Ireland's export sector, exports from other sources also contribute significantly to the national income. The activities of multinational companies based in Ireland have made it one of the largest exporters of pharmaceutical agents, medical devices and software-related goods and services in the world. Ireland's exports also relate to the activities of large Irish companies such as Ryanair, Kerry Group and Smurfit Kappa Group. And exports of mineral resources. Ireland is the 7th largest producer of zinc concentrates, and the 12th largest producer of lead concentrates. The country also has significant deposits of gypsum, limestone, and smaller quantities of copper, silver, gold, barite, and dolomite. Tourism in Ireland contributes about 4% of GDP and is a significant source of employment. Other goods exports include agri-food, cattle, beef, dairy products, and aluminium. Ireland's major imports include data processing equipment, chemicals, petroleum and petroleum products, textiles, and clothing. Financial services provided by multinational corporations based at the Irish Financial Services Centre also contribute to Irish exports. The difference between exports €894 billion and imports €455 billion resulted in an annual trade surplus of €439 billion in 2010, which is the highest trade surplus relative to GDP achieved by any EU member state. The EU is by far the country's largest trading partner, accounting for 579% of exports and 607% of imports. The United Kingdom is the most important trading partner within the EU, accounting for 154% of exports and 321% of imports. Outside the EU, the United States accounted for 232% of exports and 141% of imports in 2010. Energy. A wind farm in County Wexford. Main article, energy in Ireland ESB, ERVIA and Airtricity are the three main electricity and gas suppliers in Ireland. There are 1,982 billion cubic meters of proven reserves of gas. Natural gas extraction previously occurred at the Kinsale Head until its exhaustion. The Corrib gas field was due to come on stream in 2013-14. In 2012, the Barrieroo field was confirmed to have up to 16 billion barrels of oil in reserve, with between 160 and 600 million recoverable that could provide for Ireland's entire energy needs for up to 13 years. When it is developed in 2015-16, there have been significant efforts to increase the use of renewable and sustainable forms of energy in Ireland, particularly in wind power, with 3,000 megawatts of wind farms being constructed, some for the purpose of export. The Sustainable Energy Authority of Ireland SEAI have estimated that 65% of Ireland's 2011 energy requirements were produced by renewable sources. The SEAI have also reported an increase in energy efficiency in Ireland, with a 28% reduction in carbon emissions per house from the peak year 2005 to 2013. Transport. Main articles, transport in Ireland, rail transport in Ireland, and roads in Ireland. Terminal 2 at Dublin Airport. The country's three main international airports at Dublin, Shannon and Cork serve many European and intercontinental routes, with scheduled and chartered flights to London and Dublin. Route is the second busiest international air route in Europe, with 36 million people flying between the two cities in 2013, down from the 44 million who flew in 2003. Aer Lingus is the flag carrier of Ireland, although Ryanair is the country's largest airline. Ryanair is Europe's largest low-cost carrier, the second largest in terms of passenger numbers, and the world's largest in terms of international passenger numbers. Intercity Mark IV train at Houston Station. Railway services are provided by Ironrod ˈeÉireann Irish Rail, which operates all internal intercity, commuter and freight railway services in the country. Dublin is the centre of the network, with two main stations, Houston Station and Connolly Station, linking to the country's cities and main towns. The Enterprise Service, which runs jointly with Northern Ireland Railways, connects Dublin and Belfast. The whole of Ireland's mainline network operates on track with a gauge of 5. Program. As a result, motorways have been completed between Dublin and a number of other major Irish cities, including Cork, Limerick, Waterford and Galway. Dublin has been the focus of major projects such as the East Link and West Link toll bridges, as well as the Dublin Port Tunnel. The Jack Lynch Tunnel, under the River Lee in Cork, and the Limerick Tunnel, under the River Shannon, were two major projects outside Dublin. Several bypass projects are underway in other urban areas. Demographics. Main article, demographics of the Republic of Ireland. See also, Irish population analysis. Population of Ireland since 1951. Genetic research suggests that the earliest settlers migrated from Iberia following the most recent Ice Age after the Mesolithic, Neolithic and Bronze Age. Migrants introduced a Celtic language and culture. Migrants from the two latter eras still represent the genetic heritage of most Irish people. Gaelic tradition expanded and became the dominant form over time. Irish people are a combination of Gaelic, Norse, Anglo-Norman, French, and British ancestry. The population of Ireland stood at 4,588,252 in 2011, an increase of 82% since 2006. As of 2011, Ireland had the highest birth rate in the European Union, 16 births per 1,000 of population in 2014, 363% of births were to unmarried women. Annual population growth rates exceeded 2% during the 2002-2006 intercensal period, which was attributed to high rates of natural increase and immigration. This rate declined somewhat during the subsequent 2006-2011 intercensal period, with an average annual percentage change of 16% at the time of 2011 census. The number of non-Irish nationals was recorded at 544,357, comprising 12% of the total population. This is nearly 25 times the number of non-Irish nationals recorded in the 2002 census, 224,261. When the question of nationality was asked for the first time, the five largest non-national cohorts were Polish 122,585, UK 112,259, Lithuanian 36,683, Latvian 20,593 and Nigerian 17,642 respectively. See also, list of urban areas in the Republic of Ireland by population. Largest urban centres by population. Dublin. Limerick. Hashtag settlement. Population. Hashtag settlement. Population: Cork, Galway 1, Dublin 1,110,627, 11, Ennis 25,362, Cork 198,582, 12, Kilkenny 24,423, 3, Limerick 91,454. 13, Tralee 23,693, 4, Galway 76,778, 14, Carlow 23,035, Waterford 51,519, 15, Newbridge 21,561, 6, Drogheda 38,578. 16, Naas 20,713, 7, Dundalk 37,816, 17, Athlone 20,153, 8, Swords 36,924, 18, Portlaoise 20,145, 9, Bray 31,872. 19, Mullingar 20,103, 10, Navan 28,559, 20, Wexford 20,072. Functional urban areas. Functional urban areas population 2011, Dublin 1,794,000, Cork 406,000, Galway 179,000, Limerick 162,000. Languages. Main articles: Languages of Ireland, Irish language, Hiberno-English, and Mid-Ulster English. The percentage who said they spoke Irish daily outside the education system. In the 2011 census, the constitution describes Irish as the national language, but English as the dominant language. In the 2006 census, 39% of the population regarded themselves as competent in Irish. Irish is spoken as a community language only in a small number of rural areas, mostly in the west and south of the country, collectively known as the Gaeltacht. Except in Gaeltacht regions, road signs are usually bilingual. Most public notices and print media are in English only. While the state is officially bilingual, citizens can often struggle to access state services in Irish, and most government publications are not available in both languages, even though citizens have the right to deal with the state in Irish. Irish language media include the TV channel TG4, the radio station RTE Radio Na Gaeltachta, and online newspaper Tuairisha. In the Irish Defence Forces, all foot and arms drill commands are given in the Irish language as a result of immigration. Polish is the most widely spoken language in Ireland after English, with Irish as the third most spoken. Several other Central European languages.